Hey guys, it's Bethany. In honor of Pi Day, we thought we'd make a video. In case you didn't know, pi represents the rounded number 3.14, which is why Pi Day is celebrated on the third month of the year and on the 14th day within that month. Pretty clever. Well, pi has been around for, well, technically since the creation of a circle. You see, all pi represents is the ratio of the diameter and circumference of a circle. So whatever the diameter is equal to, the circumference of a circle will always be just a little bit greater than 3 times the diameter. Some historians say that the earliest record we have of our ancestors having an understanding of this ratio dates back to around 1650 BC on a piece of Egyptian papyrus paper. Then, after that, we see it in the Old Testament. In 1 Kings 7:23, King Solomon is building his palace, and he builds basically a pool, and we're told that it has a diameter of 10 cubits and a circumference of 30 cubits. This book was written somewhere between 561 BC and 538 BC. Later, around 250 BC, Archimedes, the Greek mathematician, calculated pi to be approximately 22 over 7 by using polygons. For thousands of years, mathematicians have been obsessed with pi, which makes total sense because we like to try and make sense of things, which has proved to be a hard thing to do with pi because it just keeps repeating and there's not a predictable pattern to it whatsoever. Most recently, pi has been calculated to 10 trillion digits by Japanese mathematician Shigeru Kondo on his homemade computer, kind of like this homemade pi. Today, people all over the world will dedicate this day to memorizing more decimal places of pi. But me, I'm just gonna eat lots of pie.
Happy Pi Day, guys. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to hit the like button and subscribe to our channel for more videos. Oh my goodness, there's something in this pie. Come look, hurry!